Hello and welcome to Designer How. Today we're going to be going over speed ramps in After Effects. We already talked about speed ramping in Premiere previously, but there actually is a way to do speed ramps as well as speed ramp transitions even faster and more efficiently. Let's get right into it. Make sure you have your composition set in the correct order. As you can see, I'm using multiple clips and already have them arranged on the timeline consecutively. Now for the speed ramp, we want to right-click the clip in question, select time, and hit time remapping. You should be seeing two keyframes now, one at the beginning and one at the end. Instead of Premiere's awkward roundabout way of adding speed ramps, AE makes it as simple as dragging some keyframes to and from each other. I have set some audio to go with the footage as well to give it some rhythm, but I won't be bothering you guys with that on every playback. I want the clip to begin with a ramp. To accomplish that, we'll move the playhead to the point in the footage where we want the increase in speed to commence, or to end in this case, because the ramp is in front and we are working backwards. Hit the keyframe button and another keyframe appears on the timeline. We'll hold down Shift and select both the middle and the ending frame and drag them towards the one at the beginning. We have already accomplished our first ramp, though I think it's still a bit too slow. No problem, we'll just pull it back a little to increase the ramp speed. And there it is, our first honest-to-God speed ramp. Isn't she precious? I want for this clip to end on a ramp as well, so that we're able to have a nice transition into the next one. The only thing we have to do is select a point in time, hit the keyframe button again, and drag the one you've just created toward the last keyframe. We'll just speed this one up a bit by dragging the keyframe some more. And we've got us another ramp. I'll repeat this process for the rest of the clips real quick so that they ramp into each other, and then we'll move on to discussing overall speed. The ending keyframe decides the speed of the footage between ramps. The faster the speed, the shorter the clip. If you speed up sections without shortening the end keyframe, logically you'll stretch the rest of the clip and thus make it run slower. So if the middle is too slow, drag both the ramp and the ending keyframe further back to increase speed. Cut the clip to where it matches the last keyframe, of course, and you're set. And this is what we've got so far. Easy. Another thing that is so much easier in AE is reversing your footage. Let's say you want to follow up on a clip with another one, but this one is moving in the opposite direction, screwing up your entire flow. No problem. In AE, it's as simple as selecting the last keyframe of the ramp before the change in direction, then moving your cursor to the timer next to your clip, and dragging it in the opposite direction. Now your speed ramp will switch and change into the correct direction, flowing nicely through into your next clip. You can even put a direction change in the middle of this clip for some added swing. Just add two keyframes wherever you think suits best and make one of them switch directions. This will get you a nice little back and forth. All good and well, but let's move on to ways to smoothen the motion of our ramps. The easy way is to select all keyframes and hit F9, turning them all into Bezier, making the motion feel more organic and less linear. But it often pays off to fine-tune them even further. Click the icon for the graph editor, and make sure that you have time remapping selected for the clip you want to tune. I usually have it selected for all my clips so I can manage them simultaneously. I find it gives me a more clear view of the whole. If you guys do it differently though, feel free to tell me how wrong I am below in the comments. Click the graph and make sure Edit Speed Graph is selected. We are able to see our speed ramp now, simply going up and coming back down. Not much happening there. Clicking on a point of the ramp will show us these handles. This method will allow you to create more interesting motion patterns to spice things up a bit. A natural kind of motion that is used a lot is coming in hot, then slowing back down. For this pattern, click on the inner point of the ramp and simply drag the handle outward horizontally. The ramp now has more of an elastic kind of feel to it. For the ending ramp, we're basically going to be using the same pattern, but because it's on the opposite end, we'll be doing it in reverse. So, coming in slow, then finishing fast instead. We do this by grabbing the inner handle and dragging it outward again. I'll finish the exact same patterns for the other clips and show you what we've got so far. Got a little more kick to it, doesn't it? To finish up our masterpiece, we'll be adding a little spice in the form of motion blur. We'll just hold shift and select all clips. Right-click on one of them and select pre-compose. Name it whatever you want. Hit OK. Now go to the Effects tab. I'm using Real Smart Motion Blur. If you don't have that though, any other motion blur will do just fine. Throw it on your pre-comp. Adjust the blur amount to what you feel suits best. And this is the end result. And that was it for this tutorial, you guys. Please like and subscribe for more videos like this, and we will definitely catch you all on the next one.